Will a vacuum chamber float on water or sink? And what will happen when you crack the vacuum chamber underwater? Well, Maximint, I think we've come up with a good way to make some small disposable vacuum chambers, so let's try it out. Rather than using a full-size vacuum chamber and putting it into, say, a large tub of water or a swimming pool, we're gonna see if we can't make a very small vacuum container just using a soda bottle. Here's the basic idea. We're going to empty out our soda bottle, drill a small hole into the lid, and add a rubber stopper. We'll put the whole bottle and stopper inside of a vacuum chamber and suck all of the air out. The stopper should prevent any air rushing back into our bottle, at which point we can see how well it floats on water compared to a bottle full of air. The first step in turning our little soda bottle here into a vacuum chamber is, of course, going to be emptying out what's already in it. Cream soda, guys. One more thing that I do want to do just to see if we're getting our vacuum is I'm gonna drop a marshmallow down into this bottle. So it won't have a complete vacuum, it'll be a vacuum with a marshmallow in it, but I think that will really help us see whether or not we're getting the effect we want. This piece of tape, it's gonna be pretty loose. You can't really see it, but there should be just enough space for air to escape out of the bottle. All right, time to fire this up, give it a test. Let's take our entire bottle with the modified lid, place it inside our vacuum chamber, and let's drop one more marshmallow down into that vacuum chamber so we can see the difference between the two. Pull out all the air and see what happens. I spy two expanding marshmallows, just what I was hoping to see. Think we've got a pretty good vacuum. Now let's see what happens if we add air back in. That marshmallow doesn't look as squished down as this one did, so I think we did manage to keep a vacuum in there. In fact, I'm gonna pull up on the rubber and see if the marshmallow changes. Oh, definitely. So we did have a vacuum in there, and then I broke the seal, and now we don't have a vacuum in there. It's just full of air and a marshmallow again. So we confirmed that it does hold a vacuum, or at least lower pressure. It might not be a complete vacuum, but it's much closer than it is now. You can see how squished that marshmallow got, poor guy. Same thing, one more time. This time though, we just aren't going to break the seal as long as it looks like everything is working. I'm gonna put another layer of tape over it to really hold down the rubber seal. Hopefully that'll prevent any leaks. Now I am providing lateral stabilization, trying to hold the bottle from falling over, but I am not holding it up at all. In fact, even if I push it down under the water, you can see that it pops back up quickly. So confirmed, a vacuum chamber does float on water. Well, I didn't actually think that a bottle with a vacuum in it was going to sink. When we think about a bottle floating, we think about the air inside of it being what keeps it afloat. What really makes the difference is whether the total density of a bottle and whatever it contains is higher or lower than the total density of the water that it displaces. The bottle full of air weighs less than the same volume of water. A bottle full of vacuum actually weighs even less than that. We don't really think of air as having much weight, but it does have mass. It's mostly made of nitrogen, oxygen, and a little bit of carbon dioxide and some other trace elements. That air, while very lightweight to us, does have some mass to it. However, we were able to test and confirm that a bottle with a vacuum in it does float on water. And now it's time to move on to the second part of the comment request, which is to see what happens if you break a vacuum chamber underwater. Well, once again, I think they mean while it has a vacuum, so let's pull all of the air out of our bottle once again, and then try and crack it underwater. Poor marshmallow friend has now been inflated and deflated and reinflated and... it's tough. Oh, that's so cool. Yeah, water is just spraying in there super fast. Yeah, that's kind of cool because those bubbles are vacuum that are just surrounded by water, and as the water fills in all of the spaces, they're dissipating. Not all of them are vacuum though, because some of them stay and are starting to float up toward the surface. Maximint, thank you for your suggestions. This has been great to experiment with. In fact, that looked so cool that I think we're gonna have to scale that up and maybe do one of our full-size vacuum jars. Just get all of the water on it, find maybe a swimming pool or something, at least a really big container of water, and something where I can get a lot more momentum and just whack it with a hammer. Get it to really crack open all at once. Maybe do that a few different times. I don't know. This was really cool. Check your YouTube inbox. We are sending you $25. And remember, if you've got a cool idea of something you want to see us do, let us know down in the comments. If we use your idea, we'll send you $25. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you're not a subscriber yet, just hit the bomb to get in the club. If you missed our last video or want to watch it again, just click up here at the top. Click down there if you want to see what the internet thinks that you should watch next. That's it for now. Have fun, be safe, and see you tomorrow.